wonder if he's as strong as he looks.
Sarah's dropped in for a visit.
It was an honor to host on the Queen's daughter.
She come for a reason? Or just to visit?
Hey, Ruva! What do you say we go hunt the cave monster?
You're daft. Even grown-ups do.
Exactly.
But damn the dogs, you don't look like one to haggle.
Show me what you got and we'll see. So long.
What? Down.
Show. So long.
We'll be done in a moment.
And then a giant sea snake swam up and bit my arm off. The gods have spoken. A sacrifice is needed.
To my mind, it's about you defeating a snake, Yar.
No. They demand a sacrifice. I'm sure of it. It's time.
We must wait for a clearer sign. At least till your next dreaming.
I don't need no more signs.
Looking for Ceres. Heard she stayed here.
Loncrite's daughter. Aye, she was here.
Where is she now?
What?
Ceres. Where's Ceres?
Dunno. Enough of the questions.
I say something wrong?
You must forgive the Jarl. Hasn't been feeling well of late.
Is he sick? He didn't seem quite right during Croch's feast, but...
Forgive me. I must go to him.
Where's Ceres? I've got to find her.
I don't know. Ask around.
Great.
Remember when that storm caught us in Old Bay? Aye, like it were yesterday.
Friend of the Isles, see if you have a cloak.
Greetings.
Ha! Nary a soul for months, then one day guests from afar start dropping like rain in springtime. You weary traveler? Hungry?
Looking for Ceres, Jarl Loncrate's daughter.
Ah, you found her. Or near to. Lass was just here.
Know where she might have gone?
Took an interest in our yarn. Asked about his childhood. So I told her to see Big Thora and Eirik.
Who are Big Thora and Eirik?
Years ago, Eirik was close with the old Jarl. Was the Jarl that helped him win Big Thora's hand. They lived toward the east end of the village.
Take care.
Bless you. And my blessings to Ceres when you see her.
First, I heard the boom. Then the blast nearby the longships off the bay. 'Twas a fallen star to my mind.
Sorry to interrupt.
You need something? Come, let's have a pint of it.
Thanks, but I'm short on time. Looking for a girl named Ceres.
Crachan Crate's daughter. She was here, but I've not seen her away.
Take care. Greetings. I'm looking for someone.
Lucky chap you are, then. Truth be told, I'm taken. But village is brimming with lovely girls.
I'm looking for Ceres.
The skinny thing. Lovely doe eyes, true, and she's from an honorable house. But the lass is gaunt as a sapling.
I don't know where she is, and her father...
Tell Crach to calm down. No Skellige lass can perish in her own isles. All right, she was here a few hours. Went to find me man Eirik. Needed to talk, she said. They should be on the beach, t'other side of the isle.
Thanks.
Good luck searching.
Come on.
Saris. Passed out. Gotta get her out of here.
What? What happened? Where am I?
Oh, my head. Pain's just awful.
Got hit with something heavy.
Geralt? Why are you here?
Came to look for you. Croc's worried. Taking you home.
I won't go until I help Ulrich.
The sword! Where's the sword? I've got to go back!
You're not going anywhere. I carried you out of there a moment ago, half dead.
I have to!
You have to tell me. So what's this sword all about?
It's Brokvar, the ancestral sword of Ulrich's clan. I need it to lift the curse that holds Ulrich.
A curse?
Long story. Years ago, Ulrich and his little brother butted heads over the sword. As custom has it, the clan's sword should go to the firstborn son, Ulrich. But his father gave Brokvar to his little brother, Aki.
Serious insult in these lands.
Serious enough for Ulrich to break a sacred law here in Skellige. He openly questioned his father's decision.
Guessing the old Jarl couldn't let it pass.
They chained Ulrich to a pile, up to his waist in the sea. Spent 3 days like that. When his punishment ended, he and Aki sailed out to fish.
Got a feeling this trip didn't end happily.
Your feeling's right. There was an accident. A storm broke out and Aki fell overboard. Ulrich had his hands full with the sails. Didn't hear his brother until it was too late.
Didn't hear? Or didn't want to hear?
Some folk on the isle had the same doubt, but none would mention it aloud.
What do you think? Did Ulrich kill Aki?
I don't want to jump to any conclusions, but I do think whatever happened at sea that day, well, it's affecting Ulrich right now. Powerfully so. And it could have something to do with that sword.
What did you plan to do with the sword?
I thought Aki's ghost would want it back.
The brother's ghost?
Long as I remember, folk have said Udelric's the chosen one. The one the gods speak. I believed it once. But now, considering certain things, I think he's just haunted. And it's his dead brother that's haunting him.
So you believe Aki's getting his revenge, because Udelric let him die?
I've talked to Jort. He swears Ulrich didn't start hearing voices till after Aki's death. And I don't think Jort's mistaken. He knew both those boys from the cradle. I think we've to give Brokvar to Aki.
Not a bad idea, on condition it's a ghost we're dealing with. But something doesn't add up.
What's that?
Aki drowned at sea, said so yourself. But the ghost haunts this house.
Aki and Ulrich both lived here. Maybe that's why. Thanks for your help, Geralt. But I've got to get the sword.
Out of the question.
Really? Thanks.
No chance. You're weak. Might pass out again along the way. Wait here, we'll go together.
to find the sword?
I found it. Let's go.
After you, then.
You and my dad, you were mates once, right?
Hope we still are.
But, well, I heard you fell out over something, or someone.
Talking about that story with Yennefer? Long time ago, that. In fact, that was before Croc met the woman who'd be your mother.
But you and Yennefer had already met?
Things were never cut and dried with Yen.
What is it about her? What is it that draws you?
Dunno. Maybe, it's because I've never chosen comfort and ease. The calm and the quiet.
Trusty axe.
I don't want to die.
What's your step?
Where is Yennefer?
Don't know. Why do you ask?
I just wonder why she let you come here alone.
What do you mean, let me?
Nothing. Not a thing. Just got the impression she doesn't like to let you out of her sight.
Look, there they are.
Horribly bright out here. Stings the eyes.
The fresh air will do you good.
The gods won't be pleased.
Jarl, our guests, remember.
What happened to your hand?
I sacrificed it to the gods.
Forgive him, Jarl. Geralt's got more to learn about our customs. We're close to the gods in Skellige. And the chummier you are, the greater the offering you make. It's our belief that the greatest thing a man can offer is his pain, his suffering, the pure sacrifice.
To hear the gods is a gift, not a sacrifice.
These voices you hear.
The gods, their voices.
It's not the gods.
Watch your words, Farner. You're in Skellige, our land, and we revere the gods here. If you weren't on Craig's guest...
Jarl, the Witcher surely meant no offense. Let us hear what he has to say.
More likely, this is somehow related to your dead brother.
I told Geralt of Aki. We conclude that...
That the gods are angry at you, yet he's the reason. That's why you have to apologize to Aki himself.
I didn't want to. Aki fell in the water. The gods will be angry.
Let me help you, and I promise to do everything I can to keep from angering the god.
Heed the Witcher, Jarl. Make amends to Aki, and you'll surely please the gods.
What would you have?
Remember where Aki fell in the water?
Near the Isle's eastern end, by the mouth of the bay.
It's a dangerous spot. Treacherous eddies swallow a handful of sailors each year.
We need to sail there. Aki's ghost won't rest until Brockvar's
No. No, no, no. The gods, they'll be angry.
Fear not, Jarl. The gods love you, and they loved Aki. Surely they want this.
Well... Maybe I can sail there. The sword should be returned. That's what matters. Makes no difference by whose hand. What do I look for? Did Aki have anything that'll help me recognize him? Something he was wearing that could survive all this time underwater?
Our clan ring.
That ought to be enough. I'm off.
Thank you.
must be the place.
You're gonna make it.
Adventure seeker.
Why'd you do it?
What is this?
Udelric. The voice has commanded him to poke out his eye.
What? Why'd you do it?
Such was the
will of the gods. A sacrifice for Aki.
What did the gods want, exactly? Do you remember? What did they tell you?
They were angry. Poke out your eye. Suffer and regret the evil you've wrought.
When did the gods speak to you? Right after I left?
Shortly after. Sleep came over me, so I lay down. 'Twas then they revealed their will to me.
You always asleep when they speak to you?
Always.
What do you see then? Do they try to summon you anywhere specific?
My old home. They command me to light torches, then speak from the shadow.
The gods always demand you offer them your suffering?
Only that pleases them, so they ask for more and more.
The gods speak from the shadows, you said. Is that why you don't allow any lights in here?
In my dreams. At times I see their form, when the torches burn bright.
To see the gods is a great honor. Maybe with more light in your house, you'd see them when you're awake as well.
Lesser men are unworthy. They cannot gaze upon their faces.
I returned the sword, but nothing's changed. It's not his brother's ghost that haunts him, tortures him.
What's wrong with him?
Can we talk somewhere in private?
The guest room. Come. Well? Know what it is?
It's a Heim, a post-conjunction creature. Very rare and very dangerous. It latches on to men who commit vile deeds. It feeds on their pain for years, fueling their guilty conscience. In the end, Heims force their victims to mutilate themselves.
Sounds unpleasant. Any way to defeat it?
They say a Heim can be tricked. You have to pretend to do something horrible. Then it'll move on to you as its new victim. When it realizes it's been tricked, it'll be forced to leave.
Great. Let's...
Don't know anyone who's pulled it off.
Maybe no one's thought up a trick. What's this other way?
Witcher's bestiaries say you have to spend a night in the Heim's lair, with the affected individual.
The haunted house, you mean? It's hardly cozy, but I wager you've slept in worse conditions.
It's not about sleeping. You've got to draw the Heim out. It has to emerge from the shadows, show itself. Can't hurt it otherwise.
And it's sure to give as good as it gets.
You've seen Udalric. It won't be an easy fight.
I know you're doubtful, but we should at least try to find a way to trick the Heim.
Might not be as simple as it seems. Besides, neither method's...
What do you mean?
Udalric might not survive an entire night in the Heim's lair.
You think the Heim... Would it try to kill Udalric?
No, that would mean losing its host. But Udalric could just... expire. He's weak, and the house will summon painful memories. Whereas to the Heim, that'll be an opportunity. The more pain the Heim causes Udalric, the stronger it'll grow.
And what about the other method?
The Heim's a demon, and demons are notoriously hard to fool. Plus, the trickster can't know it's a trick.
What?
The Heim attacks those who have a guilty conscience, truly believe they committed a foul deed. The Heim strengthens their regret and feeds on it. Meaning, if the new host doesn't feel true sorrow, the Heim will sense that.
Yes. So, for this to work, if either of us has an idea, we can't tell the other one about it.
Exactly.
Both methods seem risky. But I still think we should try the trick.
Don't know that I'm convinced.
Just please don't tell me you have to consult Yennefer on such things as well. If we fail to think of anything, we can always try the Witcher's way.
Trying the trick can't hurt.
Good decision.
Haunted house. The Heim's lair. Only place where anything like this could work.
After you, then.
No reason to delay.
Thank you.
the Axie. Calm down. You can do this. Now get back behind the torches. Gone. I can't see it.
I saw it sink into the ground.
Into the ground? Must have weakened it enough so it hid deep within its lair in the guts of the house. Listen carefully. I gotta go downstairs, finish off the Heim before it regenerates. Don't move.
Thank you.
It's over.
Over?
I killed the Heim. You're free. Let's get out of here.
Well?
It worked.
What's happening? My head's spinning. I'm spinning in a maelstrom.
Geralt, you said it was over.
That's just fatigue. In time, his mind will return to normal.
What? What will I do now?
You're disoriented, but don't worry, it'll pass.
I feel as if someone's torn something from me.
That's normal. The Heim was a parasite. Bonds between parasites and hosts can be strong. That's why you feel empty now. Give it a few days, weeks, you'll be fine.
Thank you. I think. Farewell.
I'll go with him. He seems confused.
Good idea. Then what? What are your plans?
I'll stay a few days, make sure he's healthy. And you? Gonna stay on Speaker Rock?
Don't know yet. Gotta gather my thoughts.
I'm sure Yennefer must be growing impatient.
What is it with you and Yennefer? Mentioned her several times already.
Nothing. I've just noticed that you're often of one mind.
Saying I'm henpecked.
Not that you're especially different. Seems to happen to all men. Take a rowdy Skelliger, a brave knight or a tough witcher. You all end up wrapped around some woman's finger.
Generalize much? I'd say when someone's got a good idea, there's no reason to deny it. And whether they're man, woman or dwarf doesn't come into play.
Is that why you wouldn't trust me with the Heim? It was just a bad idea?
No. Just opted to do it my way.
Worked out in the end. That's important.
Don't mention it. Farewell.